Hey everybody, John Denise coming to you from the shop today. Hey, as we're getting ready to go into springtime, the weather's looking a little bit nicer. We've had a really rough winter. I know at least here in Illinois we have. But hey, I saw some robins the other day, and so I'm starting to think more about flying, getting out and having a good time. Well, before you do that, you might want to take a look at everything you've got, you know, in your shop and also in your flight box to make sure that you're ready for, you know, the flying season. We're going to show you today a few things to help you charge into spring. We're going to check out a new charger and some other things you might not even think you need. So let's check it out right here.
If up to now you've only been using the chargers that come with your ready to fly and bind and fly aircraft, we've got some selections here that's going to be great for you. First up, we have the Profit Sport Plus from Dynamite. It's an AC-DC charger and is the great next step in charging your batteries. Now, the charger comes with everything you need to get started, including this balance adapter. The adapter plugs into the front of the charger and lets you charge anywhere from a 2S to a 6S battery, actually a 1S, but you would need a balancer for a 1S. It also comes with a charge lead already prepared with an EC3 connector. These are banana plugs, so you just plug them into the front of the charger. We've got a red and a black, and red is positive, black is negative. Now, as I mentioned, this is an AC-DC charger, so you've got an AC plug and a DC plug. For today's demonstration, we're going to be charging with the AC since we're in the shop. So the provided AC plug comes with it. Just plug that into the back of the charger. And then plug it into the wall and you'll be set to go. Now we're going to be charging an E-flite 3S 2200 milliamp battery. It's pretty standard with a lot of the Park Zone aircraft. So first thing you want to do is turn on the charger. It'll beep and flash a couple times. Now you want to plug in your battery lead. And the EC3 only plugs in one way, so you can't get that wrong. And then you want to plug the balance lead into the balance lead adapter. Now we're using a 3S, so we'll slide it into the 3S slot. And now we're about ready to get the charger going. So with the battery all hooked up, you want to push the current select button and cycle through to the current that you want. Right now we're at 2 amps, and that's what we're going to be charging this 2200 milliamp battery pack at. And then the other thing you want to do is over here on the right, the start-stop button, you'll push that to cycle through the battery types. You've got LiPo fast charge, nickel metal hydride, and what we're going to use today is the regular LiPo charge. To start the charge process, you'll press and hold the start-stop button down for about 3 seconds. You'll see the three LED lights go out, and then the red LED will flash about every 2 seconds, indicating that the charge process has begun. Now, there are a couple other products you might want to look at investing in. One is the LiPo protection bag, and the other is the balance lead adapters from Dynamite. The bag will help protect your property in case a battery shorts out during charge cycle. What you'll do is take your battery and the adapter, plug the adapter into the battery. That actually gives you a little more room to get to the adapter of the charger. Now you slide the battery in the bag, close it up, plug the balance lead into the adapter, and you're ready to charge, all in the protection of the LiPo battery sack. So once you're done charging, you'll turn your charger off and go ahead and disconnect the battery. Take off the charge lead, take off the balance adapter, and now I've got a new cool little tool I want to show you, and it's the E-flite LiPo cell voltage checker. Now what this cool little thing does is it checks each individual cell's battery voltage. You'll see numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 here on the prongs. And you look at your balance lead and you want to plug the negative or the black lead here on the bottom into the number 1 pin of the voltage checker. Once you get the battery plugged in, you'll see the display light up indicating how many cells your battery has. And the voltage, number 1 cell has 416, number 2, 418, and number 3, 418 also. So it's all pretty balanced. Great little tool to use, not only after you're done charging, but out at the field too after you're done flying to make sure the batteries are in good shape. Now one thing you might not have realized is that that CA that you opened up last year, last flying season, has gone bad and you can't get anything out of it. So it might be a good time to pick up some new CA. There's many different brands out there, but you can choose your favorite. Right here we've got the E-flite Foam Safe CA or Foam Compatible CA and Activator. Another thing you might want to pick up is some 5-minute epoxy like this Zap Z Epoxy. It's 5-minute epoxy, so it sets up really quick for quick repairs. And of course, you're probably going to need some epoxy brushes to go along with that.
Well, I hope this video has helped you out. We wanted to show you a few products you might want to look at picking up as you get ready to go into this flying season. And remember, if you have any questions or comments, be sure and contact us at editors@horizonrc.com. And remember, we'll see you out at the flying field.